All right, hey, good afternoon or morning. I'm gonna do one more video. I had four up and I'm gonna go ahead and knock them all four out just while I got a little chance today. So the title of this one's gonna be we're in the middle of a spiritual warfare. And where I'm gonna be reading from is 2 Corinthians chapter 10. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 3 through 5. All right, verses 3 to 5. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations of every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. So what do you think these strongholds are? Well, I'll give you a few examples of them. Social media, 24-hour news broadcast, the internet, and just TV in general, period. So you must understand that the world we currently live in attempts to set itself up against God and His Word. Darwinian evolution is one of the most satanic, made-up things that man has ever come up with. We have the truth in that King James Bible, and the only way you will win is to have that armor of God on and continue to stand for the light. So let me turn to Colossians chapter 1. Let me read verse 13 real quick. Colossians 1, 13. Who hath delivered us from the power of darkness and has translated us into the kingdom of his dear son. Boy, what an amazing verse. Do you understand that the power of darkness is a kingdom? You notice the contrast there, right? Power means to exercise authority. He's referring to a system whose authority is darkness. This is a spiritual kingdom. So the way Jesus Christ exercises authority over this darkness is light. Do you think that the power of darkness has effect on people today? Absolutely, it sure does. Do you think that this darkness is in our physical realm? Absolutely. Just take a look at all the country's leadership, right? Just look at all the whoever leads all these different countries, man. All you gotta do is take a look at it and just see how corrupt they are. The darkness that is in this world has rulers over it. They have no other agenda than to keep you in darkness. Stop believing this garbage that you see on TV and start reading today. Start reading that Bible. How do we combat this darkness, though? Through Jesus Christ, by studying His Word and getting your knowledge up. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 4. Everything that the satanic system produces is unfruitful. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 11. And I'll go ahead and read it to you since I'm right here close to the book of Ephesians. Flip on over to chapter 5, read verse 11 to you. And have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. Reprove them. Test them. Make sure what you're hearing is accurate. So in Ephesians chapter 6, tells us exactly what we are up against and how to put on that armor to fight against it, right? Satan's power is darkness along with all his minions. You have to put on the light to fight these bums. You have to. That's a must. And how are you going to put on that light? By getting your nose in this word right here. See how this verse says, spiritual wickedness in high places. I don't know what verse I'm referring to right there, but I didn't even put the verse down. Let me. I think it's verse 12. For we wrestle not against. At the end of verse 12, Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Right. So, where is that at? It's in high places, right? All right. So what is the church you're attending? Is it operating under the same satanic system? That spiritual wickedness in high places? Are you testing what that preacher says? Are you testing the doctrine that's coming out of his mouth every Sunday? Do you know what he's saying? Ephesians chapter 2, verse 2 clearly states that the course of this world, the course of the world is ruled by the prince of the power of the air. Who is that? Well, it's Satan. No doubt about it. You think Satan can control what you think? Sure. Just look at verse Just look at the 24-hour news stations. Not verse. I thought I said verse 24 right there. Just look at the 24-hour news broadcast. Man, they've got a narrative to push. They want to keep everybody pissed off. CNN wants to keep all the Republicans pissed off. Everybody who believes in the correct things for this country. And then you got Fox News that wants to piss all the Dems off, all the ones who want to destroy this country slowly but surely. So what about the politicians then? Well, they believe in Hegelian dialect, right? Hegelian dialect, look that up, which means order out of chaos. These people believe in that. Why do you think they create this chaos? To create an order from it. So they create the chaos in order to establish an order from the chaos. How do you think the New World Order is going to start? What is the symbol for the MWO? Do you know what that is? It's a phoenix, which is a giant bird rising out of the ashes. Man, go look this stuff up. You don't believe me. This originates from the Hindus, creating chaos to bring in order. This is exactly what Satan wants. Stop watching and reading this garbage. Stop listening to these 24-hour news broadcasts. They're just going to turn you into an evil, you know, you're going to be pulled down into that darkness. Just look at Hollywood, the universities, and all the politicians, all of politics. It's obvious that their authority is the power of darkness, no doubt about it. You must have on the light in order for the darkness to be absent, right? Just think about it. Like my brother Danny says all the time, all you got to do is go in a dark room and turn on and flick on a light switch. What happens? That darkness runs, right? Darkness flees. So darkness is absolutely nothing. All it is the absence of light, period. That's all darkness is. Once a light is shed on darkness, it flees, like I just said. I guarantee you that the majority of so-called believers actually believe the media over their Bible every day of the week, guaranteed. Bottom line is, Satan is the god of this world. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4. In whom the god of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. All right, so y'all, get off of those news stations. Get off of that social media. Hey man, I got social media, but I'm not on there all the time, man. Get into the Word of God. Study your Bible. Learn how to be able to decipher what's going on today. Grace and peace to you.